everyone. Kia ora. My name is Alitoka. This is my sign name. And my topic is the orangutan and palm oil and the issues surrounding it. Now, have you all heard about orangutans and the palm oil problem? Well, I'm going to tell you the story about it now. The orangutan is quite a large creature with long arms and orange fur. Sort of like a monkey, I suppose, almost human-like. But very wise and kind and placid, very calm. Now, they don't live here in New Zealand, nor do they live in Australia. They actually live in Borneo, which is an island. You know Australia? It's sort of in the northwest up there, is Borneo Island. Now, a while back, in the 1950s, Borneo Island was a beautiful island filled with trees and orangutans, happily swinging away in the trees in the warm sunshine. There were plenty of them. Every day they'd swing around happily. As time went on, people arrived and they saw this beautiful forest growing in the warm sunshine, lots of orangutans everywhere. And they thought, we could make some money here. They had dollar signs in their eyes. And with all those trees, they proceeded to knock them all down. And they did this to get the wood. And they would put all the big logs on the logging trucks. And out they would go, and it was sold to overseas countries. And they really did fill their pockets. Now the forest began to diminish. And the orangutans realized that their habitat was being lost. And they started to get very sad about that. People didn't care about the orangutans. They would abuse them or shoot them. But the mothers and the babies were up swinging up in the trees. They would be shot down, and they'd fall down to the ground. And the babies that survived would be gathered up and sold off to the zoos to make money. The forest was felled in order to make big fields for farms. It was all burned away. And as a consequence, the orangutans were also burned. So they made these huge fields in order to plant palm trees for the palm oil. Now, what is palm oil? Now, what happens is the palm oil trees grow and they harvest the berries. And they put that onto a big truck, which goes off to a factory. And it's taken into a machine, processed, squished down. And the palm oil is extracted from there. Now, many businesses buy palm oil and add it to products such as soap, shampoo, and chocolate, butter, and many other products as the ones shown up here. And every year, more and more trees were chopped down, vast hectares were cleared in order to plant more and more palm oil trees. And the orangutans were diminishing in number, and the trees were as well, all to make people rich, all for profit. And if nothing changes, the forest will all disappear. The orangutans will disappear. And that is a huge tragedy. Now the farmers of palm oil, which once looked only at the profit, become aware of caring about their environment and becoming more environmentally friendly. So when you go to the supermarket and the aisles there and you look at the shelves of different products, take a look at the back, the information on the back. If it's certified with palm oil, you could buy it, but if it doesn't, I urge you not to buy it. But people want to save the orangutan in the forest now. We don't want the orangutans in the forest dying anymore on Borneo Island. And the way that we could help is by going online here. You could donate money, or you could buy a cool t-shirt like this one. And my dream, one day in the future, is to fly there myself to Borneo Island, because I'm so keen on helping the orangutans and the forest and looking after them and saving them. And hopefully, you can think about supporting them as well.